Hello, my name is John Morris and I'm the author of The Clydach Murders, Miscarriage of Justice, published by Serum. The Clydach Murders is the story of one of the most brutal, sexually motivated multiple murders ever committed in Britain. In the early hours of a June morning in 1999, the South Wales Fire Services were called out to a house fire in Clydach, a small village in the Lower Swansea Valley. Soon after they arrived, they found the bodies of the four victims who lived there. 8-year-old Doris Dawson, a bedridden invalid, Mandy Power, her 34-year-old divorcee daughter, and Mandy's two young daughters, Katie, aged 10, and Emily, aged 8. They had all been brutally battered to death. Initially, suspicion fell upon two serving South Wales police officers, Stephen Lewis and Stuart Lewis, and an ex-police woman, Allison Lewis, who was sexually involved with Mandy Power, a lesbian relationship. The investigation centered on them and they were arrested after a year, but then after a few months, the case against them was inexplicably dropped. There was a furore about this, an absolute tidal wave of complaints that South Wales Police weren't doing their job properly. And within a month, their investigations led them to Dai Morris, who was a 34-year-old dyslexic builder's labourer. The police were led to him by virtue of a broken gold neck chain found at the crime scene covered in blood. The only evidence against Morris was a broken gold neck chain, lies he told to the police, and his lack of an alibi for the night in question. Nevertheless, on the basis of virtually no evidence, he was arrested, he was charged, and he was taken to court on two separate occasions. The first occasion was in 2002 at the Swansea Crown Court. That verdict was quashed because one of his legal team had a conflict of interest. In a trial which took place in 2006 in Newport, Morris was again convicted, and this time he received 4 life sentences, a minimum of 32 years in prison. I conducted a 3-year investigation into the Clydach murders, and I quickly reached the conclusion that there was something very wrong. It appeared to me that there had been a conspiracy to convict. 3 weeks after the murders, the results of the forensic investigation were handed to Detective Superintendent Martin Lloyd Evans, who told reporters that there was no DNA, fingerprint or trace evidence found at the house leading them to identify the murderer. Thus was born the myth that the Clydach murderer was forensically aware. This was a myth that was perpetuated at the trial by Patrick Harrington QC when he told the jury that Morris was conniving and careful and had wiped away all trace of his DNA and fingerprint evidence. At the first trial in the Swansea Crown Court, Mr. Justice told the jury that the murderer was forensically aware, and in the second trial, Mr. Justice McKinnon told the jury the same thing, that the murderer was forensically aware. A decade or so later, in November of 2014, it turned out the DNA evidence and fingerprint evidence had been found at 9 Kelvin Road, which clearly indicates that the initial announcement by Detective Superintendent Martin Lloyd Evans was wrong. I was very unhappy about being told that there was no forensic evidence left at the crime scene, so I consulted a forensic investigator of my own. She was a top investigator, she was a lecturer in university and a scene of crimes officer, and she told me that in a crime of this brutality, it was impossible even for the cleverest criminal to wipe away all trace of his DNA and fingerprints, yet this is what the jury had repeatedly been told. In 2014, it was discovered that evidence had been found at the property. DNA evidence had been found on a silver or wristwatch placed on Mandy Power's wrist after she was dead, on 2 spent matches, and on the wraparound denim skirt that Mandy Power was wearing at the time of her death, and on her white t-shirt also. It was virtually impossible to wipe away DNA evidence from items of this nature. It couldn't be done. There is one further piece of evidence that I've never seen mentioned anywhere, and yet it's absolutely critical to the investigation, and that is the white sports sock that the police concluded had been used as a glove by the murderer when wielding the murder weapon. If it was the case that the white sports sock had been worn for this purpose, then there is no doubt at all that the white sports sock would have been absolutely full of DNA evidence of the person who put his hand into it. But whatever evidence was found, whatever trace evidence turned up on the glove, it did not belong to Dai Morris. Therefore, on this evidence alone, Dai Morris could not be the Clydach murderer.